The Kalvari is the first of six conventional submarines for which the Navy signed a R18,798 crore contract in 2005 with French-Spanish submarine consortium, Armaris. That company was taken over by France's DCNS and its cost went up to R23,562 crore. Being derived from Naval Group's Scorpene 2000 offering, this boat has a submerged displacement of 1,585 tons. The overall length of INS Kalvari is 67.5 meters and its height is 12.3 meters. Its construction began with first cutting of steel on December 14, 2006 at MDL Yard 11,875. On April 6, 2015 she moved out of Drydock. October 27, 2015 launched and christened as INS Kalvari. On May 1, 2016 began sea trials, March 2, 2017 Maiden Exocet SM39 Missile Firing and May 26, 2017 Maiden Torpedo Firing. The submarine was delivered to the Indian Navy in September. Later on December 14, 2017 she commissioned into service. All six Scorpenes were to be delivered between 2012 and 2015, but that schedule has slipped to 2017 to 2020. The second unit of the now Kalvari class, the Khanderi, was launched in January 2017 and is currently undergoing sea trials. Karanj, which is the third boat of the class, is likely to be launched in the next few months. The remaining three boats of the class are presently in various stages of construction and the last boat is expected to be delivered by the end of 2020. According to the commissioning warrant, read out by Kalvari's first commanding officer, Captain S. Demondale, the vessel has been placed under the Navy's Western Command. This means it will primarily operate in the shallow waters of the Arabian Sea, blockading Pakistani ports and naval bases in wartime and sneaking up on enemy warships to destroy them with torpedoes and anti-ship missiles. It could also be used to blockade shipping from West Asia, entering the Arabian Sea through the Strait of Hormuz. The submarine, besides being able to conduct standard missions such as mine laying, intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, anti-submarine warfare and anti-surface warfare, in both open and closed sea conditions, will also be able to insert special forces troops via littoral waters. Being highly automated, INS Kalvari has a complement of only 31 personnel, leaving enough space for 6 SF troops and their equipment. The high yield and tensile strength of 80 hull steel allows the pressure hull to be lighter than it would be with a material that is less tough, thereby facilitating the carriage of more fuel and ammunition on board. The use of 80 hulls also makes the hull capable of withstanding high hydrostatic force levels, thereby enabling deeper dives, which in turn leads to greater stealth in operations. The test depth of INS Kalvari is likely to be 350 meters. ArcelorMittal's subsidiary Industeel is a known supplier of 80 hulls. A submarine's key attribute is stealth, since it is extremely vulnerable once an enemy detects it. INS Kalvari's albacore bow shape, propeller scheme, overall hull form which has fewer appendages, forward and aft control surfaces, than legacy forms, and the appendages themselves, have all been specifically designed to minimize hydrodynamic resistance leading to a lowering of radiated noise levels. The positioning of equipment on suspended shock-resistant cradles by using elastic mountings also contributes significantly to emitted noise reduction. In fact, the loudest pieces of equipment are put on double elastic mountings. As such, it can be said that INS Kalvari boasts a greater degree of acoustic discretion than other submarines currently operating in the Indian Ocean region. While underwater, the Kalvari's stealthy mass is propelled due to the power supplied by 360 lead-acid batteries, each weighing some 750 kilograms, to a 13-phase permanent magnet synchronous motor developed by Naval Group Arriva Jumont, which turns the propeller. The quiet synchronous motor is itself mounted on a shock-resistant cradle. The batteries are charged by two 1,250 kilowatts MAN diesel engines. This propulsive arrangement should give the Kalvari class boats a top speed of 20 knots per hour underwater while serviced at 12 knots and a submerged endurance of 6 days or the ability to traverse 1,020 kilometers underwater without the need to surface. The submarine's sonar suite is the Thales Supply TSM-2022-MKI, which according to the manufacturer is capable of long-range low-frequency detection, high-frequency detection, LF minimum detectable velocity tracking, LF mine avoidance, VHF shadow classification, HF and VHF route survey, as well as HF moored mine classification. Going by standard Indian Navy practice, it can be surmised that INS Kalvari should be able to receive very low-frequency messages via trailing antenna as well as encrypted burst communications when surfaced. INS Kalvari have two SAGM-supplied optronic masts, with one meant for attack and the other for surveillance. These are equipped with infrared/low-light-level cameras and laser range finders. INS Kalvari has a high-accuracy ring laser gyroscope at the core of its integrated navigation system, which also combines data from multi-constellation satellite updates, the boat's log, depth measurement devices and its DRM, list monitoring system. A unique feature of each of the Indian Navy's six Scorpene SSKs is an onboard tactical situational awareness display console of the kind normally found on SSNs, SSGNs and SSBNs. On this single console, the SSK's commanding officer can view overlaid electronic navigation charts, the tactical situation picture with Thales's SIMDAS. SIMDAS allows an integrated real-time view of both time-space position information TSPI and telemetry data, and it also provides an intuitive view of complex system interactions before, during and after an event. The various sensors on board INS Kalvari and any data received by it from external sources will all feed its combat management system called the Submarine Tactical Integrated Combat System. SUPTICs can choose to engage enemy targets with INS Kalvari's weapon suite, which includes the sea-skimming SM39 Exocet SM with a range of 150 km and a payload of 150 kg and the heavyweight 533mm Exocet Mod 1 torpedoes, which are already in use with the INS class submarines and will be an interim weapon for the Kalvari class boats. These weapons will be released via INS Kalvari 6 weapon launching tubes, which can be reloaded at sea. INS Kalvari is also kitted out with the C303S anti-torpedo countermeasure system for self-defense. The cells of the Indian Navy's CM-2000 Scorpene SSKs differ from those of the CM-2000 Scorpene SSKs of the Royal Malaysian Navy in both looks and content, since the former play host to the VLF buoyant cable antenna suite. Indigenous content in the Scorpene class boats is only between 30-40%. The project has helped enlarge the local vendor base capable of producing marine-grade equipment. Greater indigenous content levels are intended for any follow-on order for three more Kalvari class boats, as is being reportedly mused by New Delhi. However, systems such as CMS and optronic masts are likely to be imported for any follow-on units. The current RLG used on board could in theory be replaced by one developed by DRDO, which recently supplied the INS with a high-accuracy RLG for surface ships. DRDO's research center Armaris is known to be developing high-accuracy mirror-based RLGs that can be used on board submarines. INS Kalvari is due for its first major refit, an air-independent propulsion AIP, system developed by the Naval Materials Research Laboratory, which is a part of the DRDO, will be incorporated into the hull of the submarine by first cutting it open. This will subsequently be done to the rest of the Kalvari class boats as well, once they come in for their first refits. Beyond the use of indigenous equipment in Project 75, personnel from both MDL and the INS have gained considerable expertise and know-how with respect to contemporary welding craft and technology, test procedures and acceptance criteria. Thanks to this build program, India now has a number of welders qualified in major metal arc welding techniques used to build pressure hulls. Beyond MDL, outsourcing to private vendors has also led to a qualitative improvement in their build standards due to the stringent tolerances demanded by the program. Overall, INS Kalvari's commissioning marks a new day for SSK construction in India. The learnings are likely to be ported to Project 75I, which envisions the domestic construction of six more SSKs of contemporary design with foreign collaboration, possibly by a yard other than MDL. Meanwhile, MDL says that its hull fabrication unit is fully oiled awaiting follow-on orders.